Now let's take a look at some of the image sensors that nature has created. So here is one interesting one. It's the curious eye of the coppilia. Coppilia is a crustacean. It's like this, it's like a plankton. It actually has a long tail down here, but that's not shown. For our purposes here, we're looking at the head of it, the coppilia, and you see that it has two lenses. It has an anterior lens, an external one right here, big lens, which is forming an image. And this image is being formed down here, and then you have a posterior lens, which has a single pixel or single receptor associated with it. And it turns out that this combination of the posterior lens and the single sensor, that unit is actually mechanically scanned to obtain the complete image that's being formed by the anterior lens. So this is how it works. You see the scanning happening right there. It's just remarkable that you have, that nature has developed an eye with a mechanical scanner to actually capture spatial images. And then there is this absolutely amazing discovery that was made about 20 years ago with respect to the brittle star. So the brittle star, for the longest time, was believed not to have any eyes. In fact, it doesn't even have a brain. It just has a nervous system. And it was just really a mystery for to biologists as to how the brittle star was able to navigate the space around it and somehow not fall prey to predators. It just didn't make any sense. And then it was discovered that the entire body of the brittle star is just covered with lenses. So this is the body right here. This is a scanning electron microscope image, and you're seeing a small piece of the body. Each one of these bumps is a lens made of calcite, transparent calcite. It's roughly about 1/20th of a millimeter in diameter, and the body is covered with that. And each lens focuses light from a cone in the scene, focuses light onto one nerve bundle. And so the entire body is acting like sort of a flexible camera and is able to get a spatial distribution of the light around it. Just absolutely amazing invention by nature. And now let's take a look at an even more amazing creation of nature, which is the skin of the octopus. So I'm going to show you this video here, and I must state up front, it's not a fake video, it's a real video which was captured by Roger Hanlon, who is a marine biologist at the Woods Hole Institute. And let me show you the video first, and then we can talk about it. So you have a camera that's approaching this shrub underwater, and you suddenly see, as it gets closer, that there's an octopus there, and then it gets away. So what's going on here? Well, it turns out that the skin of the octopus has what are called chromatophores. These are these little sacs with pigments in them that if you tug on these sacs and change their shapes, you can change the color that the sac actually reflects. As a result of which, the octopus is able to manipulate, control the color and the texture of its skin and adapt it to the surface that it's actually sitting on so it can camouflage itself. Just an absolutely remarkable mechanism. Now let's talk about the human eye. So we're back to the human eye here, and in particular, we've talked about the retina, which is back here. We've talked about the fovea, but now we want to talk about the blind spot. If you remember, I mentioned that you have the image from the retina going through the blind spot to the optic nerve, and that's being carried over to the brain. So at the blind spot, you don't have any rods and cones. You have no sensors. In other words, there is no image being captured there. And what's really curious is that when you and I just stare at something, you don't see your own blind spot. You don't realize that there is actually a hole in the image that is being sent back to the brain. And that's because the brain itself essentially fills in that missing information. So you think you're seeing a complete image, but there is a hole in it, which is interesting and dangerous sometimes, because that's why often people talk about being careful about your blind spot, especially when you're driving. If you have things that show up in your blind spot, you just don't see it. So how do you figure out where your blind spot is? Very simple. So here is an experiment you can do. I assume that this image is on a screen somewhere if you're watching this video. So what you do is you shut your left eye. You shut your left eye, and with your right eye, you're going to look at the cross, which is on the left. And then you're going to move back and forth towards and away from the screen. And at some point, you're going to find that the big circle, the white circle on the right, just vanishes. It vanishes exactly when the white circle falls on your blind spot. So try this out. And if that works for you, then you can make the sun vanish in this case. And if you're into dark humor, you know that Vincent van Gogh chopped off one of his ears. Well, you can move back and forth in this case to make his ear vanish as well.